Shocky Fits with Big Glam, and I am back with another video. And as you guys can see, I am still rocking the natural look. You guys asked for it, and I'm going to give it to you. You wanted to know what my natural hair regimen is, and this is what I've been using on my natural hair. And sidebar, this is the look of the day. I don't know what this look is doing for you, but for me, this is like careless, effortless, Claire Huxtable realness, get up and go run some errands type of look. So hopefully this is reading well on camera and you guys can appreciate it. If not, oh well, so sad. It just is the look of the day. Anyway, so I'm just gonna hop right into it and just tell you guys a little bit about the products that I use on my hair. I keep it fairly simple. I don't use a whole lot of chemicals on my hair. I am completely natural. I did my big chop about 2 years ago. I wanna say New Year's Day 2014. I literally did it 2 years ago. So, is it 2014? I don't know, it was 2 years ago. So I'm 2 years post big chop. I'm completely natural. I really don't pay attention to hair typing because there's so many different discrepancies on what hair type everyone is. But if I had to like really take a wild guess, I would say I'm somewhere between like a, matter of fact, I'm probably like a 4A because my hair is not like really kinky, but it's not curly either. It's like smack dab in the middle. So I think 4A would be like a good compromise. As far as porosity, I want to say that it's low porosity. I have to use a lot of heat to infuse oils and moisture into my hair. And if I don't do that, I will literally see the product sitting on my hair. It just will not penetrate. As far as length, I will insert some pictures. Which side am I going? Okay. I'm gonna just put some pictures in here of my actual hair length. And yeah, so I originally started out my big chop about, I wanna say 6 months post last relaxer. So I'm probably like 2.5 years natural, if that makes any sense. So I fall about like right about here when my hair is fully stretched and I have my hair straightened. When it's not stretched, this is what it looks like, fully blown out, completely washed or whatnot. So I have a good amount of hair. I'm happy with the length. My ultimate hair length goals would probably be mid-back. I hope to get to mid-back 2018, maybe a little bit before then. As far as density and thickness, my hair is not as thick as it once was, and I'll put a picture right here. This was when I did a trim right before my surgery. So this is when my hair was the absolute thickest, and as you see, it's just like full and shaped and just like perfect. Now this is what the situation is, and I'm not even mad at it because as you can see, I have retained my length and actually grown some more length. But the actual thickness and luscious mane that I once had is no longer, which is okay because it'll come back. And this is why I have the hair regimen that I have now. As far as wash days, I shampoo maybe once, sometimes twice a month. And when I shampoo, I use this guy right here. I use Head & Shoulders 2-in-1 Dry Scalp Care. I use this because it has almond oil in it. I feel like for me, this is the most sensitive, this is like the most gentle product I can use to get like my hair completely clarified without my hair feeling really dry and nasty like how some shampoos will do my hair. And plus, I feel like this helps promote scalp health for me in general. So I use this on my hair, and I also use this on my daughter's hair because she's natural as well. And as far as conditioner, when I do co-washes, I like to use Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine. As you can see, my bottle is all busted up and broken and indented, and the nozzle isn't even on it anymore. This is how much I use this right here. I've been pumped the damn pump off. Okay, like it is what it is. But I use this for my cold washes. This has like a nice slick to it, so it's not like, I wouldn't use this for my deep conditions, but for my cold washes, I feel like it is really ideal, like when I wanna, you know, cold wash my hair and then braid it back down so I can protect their style. This is really good for that. I love this. Now, when my hair is feeling extremely dry, I will do a cholesterol deep condition. I feel like this right here, I coat, like after I shampoo with my Head and Shoulders and I do a cholesterol treatment, I cover my head with either a shower cap or a bag if I don't have anything else, and I will either hit it with blasts of heat from the blow dryer and then cover it with a towel so that the towel can retain the heat from the blow drying blast, or I will just like just have a towel on my head for like an hour. And I feel that this really helps infuse a lot more moisture back into my hair strands when I've gone, like say if I've gone a whole month protective styling and I haven't really babied my hair, I need this right here. This is really good. Now when I need a protein treatment and I feel like my hair is just like really limp and over moisturized, I will use this Africa's Best hair mayonnaise, and this is really good. As you can see, this is almost done. I usually get about maybe 2 uses out of this, so yeah, half a jar is good for one treatment and then the other half is good for another, so I'm due for one more treatment and then this jar will be done. What I tend to do is I tend to mix in, sometimes I'll put an egg in there just to give it another boost of protein when like I really feel it. All depends, like the one thing about natural hair is you have got to listen to your hair, you've got to really know it, you have to really pay attention to it because your hair will tell you what it needs. And so if my hair is feeling really limp and it's just like over moisturized, I really will do this and like I said, put an egg in it and mix it together and maybe put a couple different oils of my choice. I'll mention the oils later, but I'll put a little bit of oil in it with an egg, an actual cracked egg, and I'll mix it up and I'll, you know, customize my protein treatment for the needs of my hair. And I will again put that on my hair, put a bag on it, and put a towel over my head with the bag on my hair to retain the heat that my own scalp and body heat is producing, so that way my hair will be so much more healthier when it's done. And I swear it always comes out so beautiful, nice and strong and healthy, and I love it, love it, love it. When I want to do like a blowout or if I want to straighten my hair, what I tend to use as my leave out is this Organics by Africa's Best Shea Butter Detangling Moisturizing Hair Lotion. As you can see, there's 2 little girls on here. I actually discovered this because, as I said before, my daughter is natural as well. I discovered this because when she was about 2 years old, I started to use this to define her curls. And one day I ran out of some leave-in conditioner that I used to use on my hair. I tried this on my hair and I loved the way that it just gave my hair so much flow. And when I was using this before, the first time I used this, I was still relaxed and it gave my hair so much flow. I just felt like it was so good. So this is something that I've always used ever since then, and it's like a staple in my hair care regimen. Again, like I said, it gives your hair so much slip. It gives your hair, like, it coats your strands to protect it, but it also doesn't weigh it down. And I love, love, love that about this. So this is something that I use particularly when I'm blowing my hair out and straightening my hair. What I use when I know that I'm going to just have a wash day and go right back into protective styling, I use this. This is Elasta QP Olive Oil Mango Butter Leave-In Conditioner. This is kind of like, if you've ever used Cantu Shea Butter Leave-In Conditioner, it's kind of like that. It's like a cousin to that. This I like more than Cantu simply because, I mean, Cantu I don't like on my hair. Cantu I like on my daughter's hair. It gives her a better hold and it conditions her hair differently than it conditions my hair. For me, it's just always weird. I don't even know how to explain it. But for this product right here, this works best when I'm going to go straight back into a protective styling. This coats my hair. This is heavy enough to like coat it and moisturize it. And once I seal it with my oils, this is perfect. I know my hair is going to be healthy underneath of my unit, my wig, whatever. So in addition to my leave-in conditioners, I like to, I mean, it's essential. You have got to seal your hair and oil your scalp with an oil. And I have quite a bit of oils that I like to rotate through depending on my hair needs. But I will start off with the main ones that I use on a regular basis. So of course, we got the good old castor oil. I used to use Jamaican Black Castor Oil back when everybody first started finding out about it years and years ago. However, when I used that, I got good results. But when I use castor oil, regular castor oil, I got even better results. For me, I just feel like it gives me a better sensation on my scalp. It's more potent than Jamaican Black Castor Oil for me in my experience. I feel like it helps stimulate my scalp, which helps with the blood flow, which helps with the hair growth. So I really like castor oil. It's a little bit heavy, so depending on how I'm going to be styling my hair, I will go lighter or heavier with the castor oil. If I am going to do a blowout and wear my hair straight, I will definitely go lighter with this. And like I said, I will mix this in with my conditioner if I'm doing, even if I'm doing a cholesterol treatment or if I'm doing a protein treatment, whatever my deep conditioner of my choice is at that moment, I will mix castor oil in with the conditioner if I know that I'm going to be wearing my hair straight. If I'm not going to be wearing my hair straight, I will just put this in a bottle, like I'll put it in here in like a little nozzle bottle, and I'll go through and I'll section my hair off and go row by row and just oil my scalp with the castor oil in a nozzle bottle. And that's how I, you know, oil my scalp with the castor oil. My next favorite oil that I like to use besides the castor oil is, of course, coconut oil. I have extra virgin coconut oil, and it is winter time, so it is in solid form. However, if I just rub my fingers in the oil, it will loosen up and soften and liquefy again, and it makes it so much easier to use that way. Some people like to take oil by the spoonful and put it in a bowl and pop it in the microwave. Honestly, I've had a bad experience with that where the oil actually started popping, and I'm such a punk that I'm just not ever going to do that again. So I will be patient and allow my own body heat from my fingertips to melt the coconut oil if it is in solid form. And it doesn't take that long, it only takes a few seconds. However, if I am making my own oil mixture, I will take a spoon and spoon it out and spoon it into the bottle. And then the one thing that you need to remember if you are gonna make your own oil mixtures, especially if you're using a solid form oil like coconut oil, you don't wanna put more coconut oil in its solid form, mix it with a more liquefied oil, because then it'll get chunky and it won't move, and then you'll have to heat it up some way or another. So, and that's pretty good, like if you want to do a hot oil treatment, but I don't always want to do a hot oil treatment. So yeah, I make it work. So another oil that I love is grapeseed oil. This is a very fine oil, as you can see, like it's very thin, it's not heavy like the olive oil or the castor oil or whatnot. This I really love when I am wearing my hair straight and I want to seal my ends. This is really good. I will literally take a little bit of this on my fingertips and just run through each section of my hair. I part my hair in four different sections, and I take like literally fingertips worth of oil and go through each section to oil my hair when my hair is straight. This is really good. And like I just mentioned, the extra virgin olive oil, I absolutely love this. Honestly, I know like I have like a lot of generic brands, but for real, it's just oil. As long as it's extra virgin, whatever, I feel like it's all going to do the same thing. I mean, I'm not eating it, so it is what it is. But for me, I just love extra virgin olive oil. This is like definitely a staple. I will, like I said, mix this with my conditioners to help give my hair an extra boost of moisture and just infuse that into my scalp to help promote more hair growth. I really love this. Everybody that uses this that I know of loves this. You can't go wrong with extra virgin olive oil. It is what it is. And as far as like, sometimes, you know, you can go like a really long time protective styling, like a month and a half. And sometimes like when you take your style down and you take your braids down, you have like all of this crazy built up dandruffy, stinky, funky stuff going on your scalp. If the Head and Shoulders doesn't help clarify that, I know that doing an apple cider vinegar rinse will definitely help with that. I don't really have to do these too frequently, but I know that if I get extra buildup and I want to be squeaky clean without, you know, using a whole lot of sulfates or chemicals, I will use apple cider vinegar and do a rinse on my hair. And I feel like that just brings my hair right back to life. Like, I absolutely love this. And some of the other things that I use to help promote hair growth and retaining length are, if I have to use a comb to style my hair, I like to use this guy right here. What is this, like a rake comb or a shampoo comb? I don't know, but it's like fairly wide tooth, but it has long teeth on it. And I feel like this right here definitely aids in detangling with minimal tension, and it helps to detangle efficiently, quickly. And it just, I really like this comb. I've had this comb for like years. This is probably like the only comb that I will use to style my natural hair with, because I feel that I don't get as much damaging results with this comb as if I was to use a different type of comb. And the tools that you use in your hair are definitely key to helping retain your length, because you can do all of this stuff with the product, but if you're not using the right tools, it doesn't even matter, because you can put all of these products in your hair and use them efficiently. If you're putting massive amounts of heat on your hair, you're not going to retain length. You can use a fine tooth comb to detangle your hair. Guess what? You're going to have breakage. So the things that you use in addition to the products that you use to style your hair are definitely key. Some other things that you can do outside of tools and products are, you can start to drink more water, you can hydrate your body more, you can make sure that you're getting essential vitamins in your diet, make sure that you get some rest, make sure that you're not too stressed out, because sometimes stress affects people in certain ways, and one of those ways is hair loss. So you want to make sure that, you know, you're staying on an even keel, you're not too stressed out, you know, you're dealing with things effectively, because all of those things are all connected, and hair loss will be one of the things that you can experience if you are stressed out. Another thing that you can do to nourish your body is to take biotin. I take 10,000 micrograms of biotin. Sometimes I take one pill a day, sometimes I take two, one in the morning, one in the evening, and I really do feel like this has definitely helped with my whole hair journey in general. It's so wonderful. Like, I absolutely love biotin. Only thing with biotin is it will make hair grow everywhere, and sometimes it will cause your skin to flare up. Like for me, my skin flares up when I take biotin. I suffer from adult acne. I'm 28 years old and I'm still suffering from acne, and it's just a mess. But you know, you gotta take the good with the bad sometimes, and whatever, it is what it is. Just be on the lookout for that. And another thing that I use that I didn't mention in my hair regimen is, sometimes I use wild growth hair oil. This is very, very potent. This will make your hair grow. It's a whole set of instructions on here on how you use this item right here. But I discovered this years and years ago. I did not start using it until I began my hair journey, because I was so distraught about the length of my hair that I was just like,
oh my gosh, I need my hair to grow back so fast.
So I started using this, and like literally I grew 4 inches of hair within 4 months. Like, it's ridiculous. And like I said, those pictures are all gone. But what I will do is I will include some pictures from recently of how fast this oil has grown my hair. And you guys can take a look at those pictures right here. And as you can see, massive amounts of growth. And it's because of this oil, and it's because of my hair regimen. And honestly, natural hair is like a baby. You've got to nurture it. You got to raise it up right. You got to train it right. You got to take care of it and keep infusing positivity into it. So hopefully you guys got some good tips out of that and got some good ideas on some products. And again, My products, I really don't spend a whole lot of money on my products other than my oils, because you know oils can be expensive or whatnot. But as far as my products, my hair products, I really don't go breaking the bank on stuff like that. I mean, some people do and they swear by it, but I personally, I just don't. I don't really feel the need to do that because I try to keep things as simple as possible with my hair care. And at this point, I feel like if I switch products too frequently, I'm going to throw my hair off balance some way. So I just try to keep it simple, you know, just keep it simple, sweetie. So yeah, if you guys have any questions or requests or anything like that, leave them in the comment section. If you guys like this video, make sure you thumbs it up. If you know somebody that's looking for a good hair regimen and you think that this video could help them, make sure you share this video with them, because sharing is caring and we care to share, right? Yes. And make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the icon so that way you can get alerts when my new videos come out and you will be in the know. And yeah, you guys stay beautiful and grow that hair nice and long, honey. See you later. Bye.